In this video, I'm going to show you how to download and install OBS on Windows 11. Okay, so I recently upgraded my Windows from 10 to 11 and I'm testing out some of those streaming softwares that include Streamlab, Wirecast, OBS and vMix to see if they can actually work perfectly fine on Windows 11, since they clearly stated they've added the support for Windows 11 and their software can run smoothly on Windows 11. I'm actually going to test that out and to see if it's actually true or if it's not going to work at all on Windows 11, if I'm going to face one or two errors while installing or using their software on Windows 11. I've also done a video on vMix and the link is in the description below. If you're a vMix user, also check out that video and watch it as well to see if vMix adapted to the Windows 11 update or if it's not going to work or if it worked. I also talked about that in that particular video, so go and check out that video as well. But in this particular video, we're going to be looking at OBS. Maybe in our subsequent video, we'll also look at Streamlab and Wirecast as well. Okay, so we are going to see if the OBS 27, which is recently released, can actually run smoothly on Windows 11. So without any further ado, let's get straight to this particular video. If you're a returning subscriber, also give this video a thumbs up. It enables the YouTube algorithm to share this content and recommend it to other people as well, okay? And if you're just coming across this channel for the first time, also don't forget to hit that red subscribe button below and turn on the notification bell so you will always be notified whenever I update videos or upload new videos on this my YouTube channel, okay? So let me just get straight to it and show you how to download and install the OBS 27 on Windows 11. There are two ways you can actually install OBS on Windows 11. Now, the first method is using the Windows Store, which is this. All you have to do is open your Windows Store and search for, you can see the search bar up there, and search for OBS. Hit the search enter and you're going to see it right there. I'm just going to allow it to load. You can see OBS Studio. I see it here and you can install it from here, okay, provided and updated by OBS project. You see, you can also update it from here, so whichever updates they are releasing or a new update they are releasing, you can also update it through the Windows Store. You can also download it from here. The second method is by going to online, maybe your browser Chrome, and just type OBS there, okay, hit the enter button and click on the first link, and from here you can also download OBS from here. You can see the window, the Mac and the Linux users there. Just click on the Windows and once it loads, it starts downloading automatically. I'm just going to cancel that, okay? So these are the two ways you can actually download and install OBS on Windows 11, okay? So I'm just going to install it from the Microsoft Store. In case you don't want to follow this method, you can also go to Chrome, like I said before, and download it from the OBS website itself, okay? So I'm just going to install it from here and see what happens, okay? So it's currently downloading and let's see if it will download and we can make use of it like the normal OBS software, okay? So our OBS software has finished downloading and also installed on our PC from the Microsoft Store, okay? So I'm just going to open it and see if it's going to work, okay? So this is it, just double click on it, the OBS that we recently installed from the Microsoft Store, okay? So this is it. It's going to asking us usage information, specify what you want to use the program for, okay? Optimize for streaming, recording is secondary, okay? So I'm just going to select the first one. And okay, video settings, specify the video settings you would like to use. I don't want it to make use of my laptop screen resolution. I'm just going to select 1080 for that. And then the FBPS, okay, 30 or 60 or 30, but prefer 60 when possible. I'm just going to reduce that. So okay, let's leave it as that and click on next, asking us please enter your stream information, okay, because this is currently the first time we are using it. That's why it's asking for all this information, Facebook Live, stream, and I'm just going to cancel that, and this is it. It's working perfectly fine, though it's not showing anything here because I'm making use of my webcam on the recording screen recording software that I'm currently making use of. Just going to go over to studio mode, okay? So I'm just going to bring in a video or rather a picture to it and see if it's going to come up here on OBS. Click on browse and this is it. Once that is up, go over to this particular picture and open it. Once it's up, click on OK and that's it. I'm just going to scale this, reduce it a little bit. Okay, guess it's too big, just reduce it a little bit so it can fit in on our screen. Okay. So this is it. Just do anything you want and then put it in. You can see how it looks like. So everything is working perfectly fine. I would have loved to bring in the webcam here and show you also, but I'm using it for the screen recording software that I'm currently making use of, so I can also use it here. It's not going to work like that. Okay, so the OBS is working perfectly fine and you can test out any of the settings you want to do. Just click on the settings and you can just do your settings or whichever one you want to do. The dark default, you can change it to Israel, or you can leave it as, you see, as the color has changed, or the theme, you can select anything you want and it's going to work perfectly fine on the streaming. And just select any of the streaming software. I'm also going to be making some videos about OBS and also how you can also do more, or rather do whatever thing you want to do with it, just like I've also done on vMix.